have problems of understanding English, I think also for communication, please understand. So I was planning to request the organizers, because my ability to communicate in Telugu is non-existent. I cannot tell you English communication in Telugu. That ability I don't have. All of us have strength and weakness, madam told us just now. That is my weakness. If you ask me to give 1 hour lecture in English, I can. Those of you who have problem of understanding what I'm saying will approach sir and them. That will be a great help for communication, because we need to constantly communicate, and we need to constantly communicate in English. Please remember that all of us already know our mother tongue very well, isn't it? We all know excellent mother tongue. Then why are we practicing that again and again? We love to use our own mother tongue. I also don't like English, but I'm compelled to speak English because I'm an English teacher. I can't help myself. If I say I don't want to teach English, then the vice chancellor will ask me to go home. He say, please go home and do what you want. If you come to the university, there is only one job you have, not follow what I'm saying. Now let me proceed to what I wanted to say. Remember that communication depends on practice. By listening in this hall, you are developing listening communication. First point. For, you know, it is called LSRW. LSRW, listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Remember the example I gave you of your writing in books. Our education system teaches you beautifully to read and write English. No problem. Students come with memo, you know, 80 marks in English. They can't speak. They say, madam, we have 80 marks, but we can't speak English. They can write. If we speak, they can't understand. If my speech I write down on the board or show it on the LCD, they can immediately understand. Speaking, listening, problem. This is what you have to now find out about yourself. This whole course which is being organized for you is a self-improvement course. Please remember that all of us can give you lectures, communication skills. I can't improve your communication. Who can improve it? You yourself. Therefore, go to the market, buy one capsule, morning one. Is it possible? Willing to do it? Let us see. You know, your hard work will tell in your lives. Now see, you are communicating by clapping. You are communicating by looking in front. All these are communications which move our oral and written communication, mainly oral. All of you are aspirants for jobs, am I right? You know, they are all aiming for jobs. Now what you require in a job is that you should have excellent communication. If you are after getting a job, you want to be popular with your colleagues, you need excellent communication. If you want to have friends, you need excellent communication. If you want to have peace in your family, you need excellent communication. Without communication, you cannot do anything. So in this communication, you must start by asking yourself some questions. First, I told you already one question. Do you remember? Anybody remembers? Very good. So if you are happy and you remember it and you are comfortable with what is happening, let us go ahead. Now you have to ask a question like I asked you. When you listen to I'm speaking very slowly, not like this. When you listen to English generally, can you understand? How much percentage can you understand? 100%? 50%? 20%? Now you are giving marks to yourself. Self-improvement is a wonderful course, you know, where you are the teacher and you are the student. Suppose in your public exam or in the, you know, entrance exams, they tell you, please come with your question paper. How will you feel? You know, they are telling you, students, please get your question paper and come. Will you be happy or sad? It is impossible, no? It seems like some dream where they don't give tough paper, they ask you to get the question. Second, once you finish writing, they tell you, please correct your papers yourself. Can you imagine? What will happen? You'll say, oh, why should I correct my paper? I'll give myself 100 on 100. No, you have to give marks and you have to improve yourself, promote yourself. So please start by asking, when you listen to English, how much English can you understand? For this you have to listen. You know, without doing the exam, you can't evaluate. So please listen to every day to minimum 5 or 10 minutes of English. Minimum 5-10 minutes of English every day, and then give marks for a week or 10 days. Can you do that? All above? I should look up there also sometimes, though I can't see you very well. You know, communication, I need to communicate with them also. But only this part of my head is communicating with them. My eyes are here because the light glares into my eyes. Anyway, if you have any questions, any doubt, 5 minutes, you can evaluate by saying, more valuable than money. Money is easy. Time is difficult. Energy is difficult. So once you find out your, you know, if we are going to speak to you once and go away, you will not remember the language. You will remember only ideas. Ideas come first. So when I speak to you in English, you are not listening to my English. You are listening to the points or to the meaning which I am telling you. Is that right? Nobody bothers about the language. That is why our communication is faulty. Excellent communication comes from excellent hold over the language. So now, having asked yourself a question and done an exercise of evaluation, now what are you doing? Improvement. How will you improve? Listen every day, small passage, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. But don't listen once. Listen minimum 5 or 10 times. Sometimes students tell me that they listen 20 times because your mind is like, you know, a supercomputer. How many GB space there is? Nobody knows. Endless GB. What are the files you have stored? English? Zero. No file. So what will you recover? When you want to communicate, you are searching for that file here. No file is there. It is like my PowerPoint, I don't have. You know, today I can't show you a PowerPoint because I don't have. If I search in the hard disk, can I find a PowerPoint which I didn't prepare? I can't find. Can you find English in your hard disk when you have not stored any English there? Now you are storing. Listening and reading are storing the data in the mind. So listen not once. Listen many times. It becomes a part of our memory. So that when we speak and write, we reproduce this memory. Does it make any sense? Are you going to practice it? See, there are two levels of communication here. One is you say, oh madam, wonderful. Sir was saying how many SMSs came last year. You know, whole night I was awake because everybody was sending me SMS. I felt very happy. Oh, wonderful. But how many practiced? To say it is wonderful is one thing. No need to say at all. To say it is useful, you have to practice. You know, to say, madam, you gave an impressive lecture is very easy. To say that the lecture was useful is very difficult. I don't want any SMS this time. I'm saying it very clearly. Which says, your lecture was good. I don't want to know how my lecture is. Because I have a good job. I don't need a job. I want the communication to be interesting, useful to you. So that SMS should come to me after a month or 2 months, after 6 months or after a year. Many impact students keep in touch after 1 year. Many students whom I taught 20 years back keep in touch today. So please be like that. So start with practicing, listening every day, 5 minutes, minimum 5 times. After doing it for a week or 10 days or 1 month, no need to do so much. Then you can do little. But first it has to be done every day. Then we come to speaking. Again, start by asking a question. You know, now we are giving entrance exam to get into communication. This is the entrance exam questions. When you speak English, you have to ask yourself, is everybody following? Clearly, when you speak English, how do you feel? I want you to tell yourself, I want to ask yourselves, no need to tell me, ask yourself, when you have to speak English, do you feel comfortable? Do you feel frightened? Do you feel hesitant? Do you feel reluctant? So many possible feelings are there. When somebody asks you to speak English, do you hesitate? You know, no, not now. Not at all. Don't worry, you are not the only person who does it. The great speaker Vivekananda, when he went to Chicago Parliament of Religions, his name was called on 11th September. You know, he was supposed to speak for 3 minutes on the stage. Many speakers were sitting. They called him, Vivekananda, will you speak? No. Swami Vivekananda said, no, I can't speak now. I'll speak later. Why? Because thousands of people whose mother tongue is English, he is a speaker from India who had never given such a big public lecture in English. He had spoken in his mother tongue, but not English. So he was nervous. Finally, they told him, if you don't speak, we will cut off your name. Vivekananda said, I came from thousands of kilometers to speak. Therefore, I can't go back without speaking. So he got up and he spoke only 3 minutes. 1 year, you know, 100 years and 20 years earlier. 120 years are finished. Even today people remember that speech. Imagine, not one day. So if you feel frightened, if you feel nervous, it is excellent. Don't be scared. If you feel very scared to speak English, that is a very good beginning. If you feel lack of confidence, that is a very good beginning. Because if you get 20 marks, you can improve 80 marks. Don't you think? If you get 80 already, you can improve only 20. Isn't it more exciting to improve 80 than to improve 20? So if you are unhappy speaking English, I am very happy. I want you to be unhappy. But don't live with that unhappiness. Try to change that unhappiness into happiness, into comfort. Therefore, after asking yourself how you feel, now you must begin your practice. See, everything begins with a question. The skill, the question. Listening, we began with one question. Then I gave you how to practice to improve your listening. Now I gave you a question for speaking. Next, the practice. Speak English whenever you get a chance, even if it is not correct English. No need to have correct English first. First speak. Have you heard a child speaking the mother tongue? Grammar is all wrong. Pronunciation is all wrong. Vocabulary is all wrong. Does the child feel embarrassed to speak? Have you ever seen a child keeping quiet by saying, "No, I'm embarrassed, I can't speak"? All of us are very embarrassed to speak English. Are we not? You say, "Oh, somebody will laugh." Speak. Now, how to speak? Second point. Because I'm in front of a large group of people, I'm speaking loudly. I'm speaking slowly. I'm not speaking as fast as if I met you individually. If I met one person and I spoke so loudly, what would you think? This madam is mad, something wrong with her. Don't you think? How to speak? What language, what vocabulary should I use? Useful to you. If I talk about communication skills to you, I must tell you certain things which are useful to you. Suppose I am speaking to teachers of English. Topic is same, communication skills. I must change. If I tell them these things, they will laugh. They say, "We teach these to our students. What are you telling us?" I have to tell different things to them. So context determines our speech. Very often we use words and constructions which are not suitable. Then we have to be very careful about which situation, how we should speak. This is important. Then how much to speak, very important. When you go into the interview hall, the interviewer wants to know you. So they ask you the first question. Please tell us about yourself. Please tell us about yourself. Simple question. The answer to this question should be at least 2-3 minutes long, explaining all your strengths, because the interviewer will base the interview on your introduction. But what people do, you know, I was looking after placements for 5 years, I know this. What the student does after going to the room is, they say, "My name is so and so." Silence. "Please tell something more about you." No, only name. Maximum qualification. I have done B.Tech, or I have done B.Sc, or I have done M.A. Finished introduction. You are given a platform. How much to speak? You spoke too less. Then you went for a dinner party. There you have to shake hands and say, "Hello, I'm so and so." Only name. There you don't do that. You shake the hand and you say, "Wait, you know, I'm a very important person." You speak for 5 minutes about yourself. In the dinner party, nobody wants you to speak. They only want to know your name. In the interview, you didn't speak. In the dinner, you spoke too much. So how much to speak? Very, very significant points in speaking. So when you practice, you have to practice keeping these things in mind. I won't spend much time on written communication, because as I told you, students have very good written communication. I won't talk about it. If any of you wants to know about written communication, my email and my phone number will be with you. You can always ask me. I will help you. I'll meet you personally and help whoever wants my help. Thank you. But please remember that you are your best teacher. The great sage Ramakrishna used to say, your mind is your best teacher. Not an external teacher, we don't need. It's only you. So let me spend a little more time on how to better your listening and speaking communication. Should I do that? Are all of you happy? Comfortable? No problem. Very good. Now, when we are communicating, listening and speaking, we are using a medium. The medium is the language. So you have to keep in mind two things. One is the content. Content means the ideas, the points. And the other is the medium. The medium is the language. Till now, whatever I have told you is about the content. How to speak, how, what to speak, etc. are all related to the points you're going to make. Suppose they ask you a question on your subject, you know, whichever subject you have qualification in, you can speak a lot, don't you think? Easily you can give one lecture. If they speak you about, they ask you to speak about a general subject, no idea. Students have real problem when it comes to general topics of speaking. Subject, they can speak very well. We have regular seminars. Students come and speak wonderfully. Internet is there. You can browse and see your subject. But internet teaches you wonderful communication also. How many of us are using it? We say internet is very bad, you know, people see pornography. The language component of communication. When you are practicing listening, 5 minutes, five times. Do you remember? When you are practicing speaking, 5 minutes, what are you going to evaluate? First, are you using correct language? This is called as grammar. Grammar. You know, structures of English. Very often when we learn English from a second language, you know, very many of us learn our mother tongue and then we learn English. It is natural. So English is second, third or fourth language. Now when you want to improve, what you do is you translate from your mother tongue. Many of us do that even today. You ask yourself, somebody asks you, how are you feeling? You smile and you say, I'll tell you tomorrow. Why? Don't you know how you're feeling today? You know, but you can't say it in 10 sentences in English. You know, to make 10 sentences, I need 24 hours. So tomorrow I will come and tell you how I was feeling yesterday. There is a gap between thinking and speaking because we are translating. Now try to learn English separately from your mother tongue. You know, this is a self-learning. Don't ask, madam, which book? That is the usual question, you know. Anybody I say grammar, they say which book? They run to, you know, Abbots and they buy a book. Then the book is on the shelf and you are in your room very comfortably both. No communication. No communication than the book and you. You know, it is like the story of that pandit who goes in a boat. And he keeps telling how many books he has read. He says, oh, I read so many books. I read, you know, 100 books. He was telling about Gita Upanishads, but let us imagine he was telling about swimming. He says, I read, you know, 20 books on swimming. The poor boatman has not read a single book. He's illiterate. When the storm comes, the boatman says, sir, you read 20 books on swimming. Do you know how to swim? Pandit says, no, I was so busy reading a book. Why will I learn to swim? I learned from the books. Then boatman says, sorry, I know how to swim. I have not read a book. Many of us have not learned grammar in our own mother tongue. I have not learned because I know my mother tongue by practicing at home, not by reading in school and college. Because I stayed, you know, from birth I am in Hyderabad. I can read and write Telugu. I can read and write my mother tongue also, but not formally, not grammatically. Grammatical I didn't learn. But when I speak my mother tongue, I don't make a single grammatical mistake. How did I learn? By listening. Very good. Whoever said it deserves a, you know, good clap. By listening. So when I told you, please listen 5 times, all of you looked worried. You say, this madam doesn't know us, you know, we are very brilliant. Just now madam told you you're brilliant. I know all of you are brilliant. So you must be thinking, this madam thinks we are fools, so she says, listen 10 times. I'm not thinking that you are incapable. You know, today Indians are certified as intelligent all over the world. It is not only, not only in India that we think we are good. But why, if we have so much resource, so much intelligence, so great brains in our country, country doesn't progress? Because not only are we first in intelligence, we are also first in laziness. Very lazy. You know, 2 hours if I work, I think, oh, today I worked 2 hours. In Japan, it seems, if they waste 2 hours, they think, oh, today I wasted 2 hours. Imagine, they are working 24 hours, we are working 2 hours. So it will take us 12 times more years to progress than they progressed. If they progressed in 100 years, we will need 1200 years. By then you and I won't be around to see whether we really progressed or not. So please begin, when you listen, analyze grammar. What is the kind of structures that are being spoken in those 5 minutes? Make the structures a part of your memory. In a question we say, are you coming? That is the structure in English. Are you coming? Tone has changed, structure has changed. We don't do that. Because in our language, that is such a structure doesn't exist. We say, you are coming. You are coming is a statement. Even if you change your intonation, it does not become a question in English. It is such a small thing which you learned, I think, in your first or second class. Because English is there everywhere. You know, when my students come and tell me, madam, I'm from English medium, I ask them a question which I'm asking you. Is there no English in the 10th class exam? Have any of you passed SSC without English? No? Have you passed intermediate without English? Did you fail in those memos in English? You passed. Some of you got wonderful marks. I know that. You know, I'm teaching before you were born. So I know all these things. I have seen from experience that in spite of learning 12 years of English, we still say I'm from Telugu medium, and we still say, madam, please give marks, I'm a poor boy. This is not correct. You know, we should have self-respect. We should say that I'm the best. I'm that excellent being who, you know, all perfection is there in me. So perfection means English also. It is there in me. Now I must find where is that perfection. So look at the structures. When you listen to a 5-minute speech every day, anything, look at a news channel. Listen 5 minutes and switch off the channel. Don't listen continuously. Don't listen for meaning only. Listen for language. Same part, repeatedly you listen. And then once you have listened like that, you will find within a week, you don't have to wait 6 months, 10 months. Within a week, your communication will improve. If it doesn't improve, you can fight with me. Okay, I'm giving you full freedom now to call up and say, madam, what you said is useless. If you tell me such a thing, I'll be happy. Because then you will be proving me wrong. I love that kind of confrontation. So all of you, please remember that when you are listening, always listen to the structures. How is a sentence constructed? Second, when you speak, try to reproduce these structures. Grammar is an important point of language, not to be learnt from books, but from real context, real listening. So don't read a grammar book anymore. Don't go to a class of grammar anymore, not necessary. But when you listen 5 minutes, listen to each sentence as a unit of correct English, as a unit of grammar. Then you go to what is called as vocabulary. The number of words we know make us good communicators. Suppose I ask you, how's the weather? You say, good. If I ask you, how's this book? Again you say, good. Because the word good comes immediately to mind. Or we say, fantastic. You know, today students love using the word. Awesome. Very easily it comes. Why we don't have other words? If I ask you, how's the book? Can't you say interesting instead of saying awesome? Then you're using two words. Because in front of our mind, only small number of words are there. At the back of the mind, huge vocabulary is there. Now you have to transfer, you know, from the back, transfer to the front. How will you do it? If you know a word approximately, keep using it every day. Use it 5 times, 10 times every day, till that word becomes familiar to you. This familiarity will increase your vocabulary. So when you speak and when you listen, every day you must try to improve your vocabulary at least by 2 to 3 words, not new words. Please understand, I'm not saying that you prepare for GMAT or GRE vocabulary. No, that is a different course, not today, some other day. When you are preparing communication skills, try to make familiar words into usable words. Familiar means I know. Usable means I can use it in my communication. Familiar means I can't use, I only know. If you use, I feel happy, but I can't use. You shouldn't do that. Vocabulary should improve. And then pronunciation. When I started speaking, I told you that I'm going to speak English. Do you remember? By now you have forgotten that I'm speaking English. Remember, all of us understand by translation. You know, we don't understand what is being spoken. We all translate what the speaker is saying and understand. We might be translating English to English. English to Telugu, English to Urdu, English to Hindi, or any other language to any other language. But every communication is translation. So when you have translated for 1 hour, you have become so comfortable that you forgot that I was speaking English. Now let me remind you, I'm pronouncing each word clearly. Did you get this idea? you know, when I spoke English, could you understand every aspect, every word of what I was trying to tell you? Is there any word which I pronounced half? You know, I'm hungry now, so I feel like eating off half my word. That is what people do. When they are speaking, they speak half. Why? Because in our mother tongue, the sentence begins with a lot of emphasis and ends on a slow note. When we are pronouncing English, English begins with a stress, it ends with a stress. Both words are nouns, we have to give with lot of force. What is your name if I ask? The student begins by saying, my name is Anush. What did I understand? Are you ashamed of your name? Do you want to change your name? No, no, madam, I'm very happy with my name. What is your name? I couldn't hear. This is pronunciation. When you listen to English, either on the internet or on television or in a program, try to use your machine. You know, God gave a beautiful machine, free of cost. No money you had to pay for it. If you touch here, you can get vocal cords. Nose is there, mouth is there, tongue is there, teeth, lips. The air comes from the lungs out. Sound comes. Animals cannot speak like us. They can make some sounds. Human beings can speak lots of things. Are we not human? Are we human or not? Let us decide. You know, having two legs and standing straight, head on top, is not human. Human implies that we should have humanity, the qualities of being human. Therefore, when we improve, when you speak English, speak it like English. When you speak Telugu, don't anglicize Telugu. You know, I find people who know very good English are pronouncing Telugu in a strange way. Please don't destroy the mother tongue. When you are speaking some other language, don't destroy that. Don't pronounce English with any other pronunciation than that is required for English. When you are a job aspirant, the final stage of your job is an interview. And the moment you open your mouth, the interviewer has either written selected or rejected. Pronunciation. You know, you have to take what is called as a resume. I tell my students, please pronounce not resume but resume. There is a small e at the end which is not there in the verb form. The noun form only has the e. Why it is mispronounced is because we have heard only the wrong pronunciation. Listening leads to speaking. So if our English is not good, let us not blame ourselves. Let us blame our teachers who made a mess of our English. I can't scold my students, you know, when they don't know English. I only give them a warning that when you become English teachers, don't destroy the life of students. If you had good English teachers, you wouldn't be in, you know, such a difficulty today with communication. Communication comes to us with the right kind of practice. Have I repeated this enough number of times? You know, unless I repeat, you won't remember. When we keep repeating, teachers have this, you know, fault of repeating ourselves. We keep saying, did you understand? Is that clear? Okay? All right? Are you comfortable? We don't even expect an answer. We keep asking because we are keeping ourselves also active. We are keeping ourselves alive. Therefore, when you want to improve your communication, I have given you only how to improve listening and speaking. Last year I did reading and writing also. I found from the feedback that reading, writing doesn't interest you much. Am I right? Because you already know, you know, I know how my students are. When I show them, you know, we have a paper called Film and Literature where I have to show them the movies. where the movies, English movies, have subtitle, my boys are very happy. Because they are reading the subtitle, they are not listening to the conversation. One movie I showed them about learning English called My Fair Lady. You know, it's a beautiful movie for learning English. No subtitle. They said, Madam, how will we understand no subtitle? Which means their skill for reading is much better than their skill for listening. So I don't want to talk about things which you already know. What I would like to talk to you about in a brief time, which 5 minutes? Which I can take is that non-verbal communication. For an interview, for any success in life, for attending a lecture course like this, what we need to have is the right kind of non-verbal communication. Now suppose I come to the hall and I find all of you are sleeping. What is the communication you are giving me? Nobody has spoken one word also, but the whole hall is sleeping. Yes. Madam, please go. Clear. Or you don't even have to sleep, you know. You look at your watch like this. I'm speaking to you. You look at your watch. What are you saying? Stop. Enough, enough. Please stop. Did you say one word also to me? You didn't say. Non-verbal. Non-verbal means without using words. My friend is there in that corner, or my student is here in front of me. I can smile, you know, without saying one word. What did I do? I exchanged communication. None of you knows why we are smiling. We exchanged some communication. So your non-verbal skills are very important. Once I remember in NIT Warangal, I told a group of students who were going for an interview that, you know, when you go to the interview hall, please don't sit on the edge of the chair because then you might fall down. A very fat student came. We were having interviews, you know, in camera, mock interview. The student came and he sat like that in the chair. Interview, imagine, it's being recorded on camera. I said, why? His name was, I think, Satish or something, many years back. Why, Satish, why are you sitting like that? Madam, you told me in the class that I should sit comfortably. I'm sitting comfortably. Non-verbal, you know, when I say verbally sit comfortably, do I mean to say that in the interview halls, I was taking police officers to them whether this is true? It seems if a police officer asks you a question and you look here and there inside the jail, because that means you're not telling the truth. What is your name?
My name is...
Finished. That means you're telling lies. So looking at the eyes means that you're telling the truth. Now, students, you know, the principal has called them to scold them. Because they did some mischief, the principal said, please come. The students went and started looking at him like this. Eye contact. Madam, you said eye contact, so we were looking at the principal when he was scolding us. When somebody is scolding, please look at the floor. Don't look at them, because at that point eye contact is not necessary. Where to do what? When you go for an interview hall, suppose there are 5 members, don't look at 1 member. Look at all of them. When they expect you to answer, you know, one person asks and that person expects the answer, speak one line to that person and the remaining lines to the others. We keep looking at one person as though nobody else exists. These are all what we call as contextual communication. I mentioned already communication ethics. Very important point is there, communication etiquette. How will you speak to the boss? Like you speak to your friend? No. How will you speak to a person younger than you? How will you speak to a person older than you? Communication etiquette. When you practice speaking and listening, please practice also these things. You know, when you are speaking, stand in front of a mirror and observe yourself. Some people keep doing like that when they are speaking. You know, they keep doing like this. Some people keep fiddling behind their back. You know, they're doing something. We don't know what they are.